Alright, so how we start this project is we're going to lay out our grid. Every person, every mini, is usually a 1-inch diameter. So what we're going to do is make a bookshelf that covers 2 inches, which will be 5 popsicle sticks. So what we're going to do is we're going to take them, glue each side, stick them on parchment paper. And I use parchment paper because not even hot glue sticks to this stuff. It's just peels right off. It's the same thing you use for baking cookies and stuff like that. So I'm going to glue them all together side by side, stick them together. I'm going to put glue over the top of it, spread the glue, and then allow that to sit. Once that's done, we'll come back. Alright, so once that's dry, one solid piece, I cut it in half, a little less than half, because I want it a pretty good scale for our minis. This is a short mini. So a normal size mini would be pretty, it's a good size bookshelf for like a library. You want it a little taller than your mini. So what we're going to do from this point is I'm going to follow the same thing. I'm going to cut the popsicles to length. But now I'm going to box it in. So we're going to put on top of the wood, I'm going to glue here, back here, and then side. Then go back and put the shelving. I recommend only doing 3 shelves because once you get to your final product, you want room to put stuff on your shelves. So if you put an abundance of shelves, you're just going to have an empty shelf case because you can't fit anything on it. This is all dried up. We take it and fold our sandpaper flat against the cutting board and just drag it and get off all those overlapping edges because we want a finished clean product. We don't want it to. All right, now what we're gonna do is we're going to first apply our dark coat. I don't spray these with black spray paint because we used popsicle sticks, so it's real wood, and I don't want to cover that wood grain up. That lends to what we are trying to achieve by painting it brown like wood. So I'm going to go ahead and finish coating this. I'm going to let it dry, and then we will come back and put a different base coat on it. Perfect, but I don't want it to be because I want it to look aged, and that helps lend to the wood texture. So what I'm gonna do is I have a really bad brush, very bristly, harsh. I'm gonna take a lighter brown and dry brush. I'm not going for full coverage, I just want it to look aged and weathered. My method, if done correctly, takes a little longer to paint, but it comes out looking a little bit better, a little bit more realistic than just slapping paint on it and wishing for the best. So let me get this on there. So you can see that it's pulling that wood texture out of it. It's very, very minimal. That side is a little too much for me, so I'm gonna go back and fix this. But anyway, so do this for each individual slat or beam of wood if you didn't use individual popsicle sticks, and you used cardboard. Just follow the same kind of trajectory as if you had use popsicle sticks and do vertical slats. That way it looks like it's built with real wood rather than cardboard.
So I'm gonna go ahead and finish this, and I will be back with you when it's done.
Great. While that is gluing, how about let's make some books. So I cut out a piece of Dollar Tree foam board, the same width, if not just a hair shy of a popsicle stick, because that is the width of our shelf. So what I'm gonna do is apply glue pretty generously. And I'm using construction paper as its base because once it's painted, that construction paper leaves a really good texture of aged texture. And I'm just going to place this down, let it adhere. All right, and I have two cuts. This is an edge cut, and you can tell that one of them is more narrow and the other is wider. The piece that's wider is where I cut with the razor. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna leave the wider part toward the outside. That way, it looks like the book has been old, it's used, and old used books expand where they've been opened. So I'm going to take this and fold it this way, because that is the direction of the bind, of the book bind, okay? So, I'm going to make sure that I'm completely over to the edge. I want to make sure I don't have any wrinkle back here. I want a nice flat, back, okay? So we're just going to apply pressure. I'm squeezing down as I'm doing this. Alright. And now I'm going to let that sit for a little while, let it dry. Alright, this is painted. And while this dries, I'm going to show you how to do the books. I have, just in case you're wondering, I have a little portable USB fan that I use. It doesn't blow hard by any means, so it's really good for little minis and things like that that get blown away very easy. So, let's get to it. Here is our books. You can see this is going to be the outside where the pages will be. It's covered. Here's our bind. So that's the flat part. So I'm just going to take these scissors and just follow this crease. Now, it's going to give us an overlap, and I'm not worried about that because we're going to address that afterwards. Let's get this out of the way. All right, so we have just a giant stick, basically. Again, our bind side, page side. So, what you wanna do is cut it. Again, it's the width of our shelf. If I cut with scissors, it's going to pinch it because it's just foam. And what that does is it gives a weird bent end. So to avoid that, take a sharp razor knife and just gently go through, and if it takes a few times, just don't fight it, don't force it, and that gives you a nice fluffy inside. As you could tell, some of these didn't sit so well, which isn't a big problem at all. We're going to take our brush, apply some more glue, very, very little, you don't need a lot. Take our brush and fill it back. When you're not using that brush, definitely put it back in the water, because you'll have a sticky brush that'll be useless. Alright, so here we go. We have fluffy pages on this side. It tapers down to the bind on the back. We're going to let this dry for a little bit longer. I'm going to cut out a few more pieces, glue them together,
and we'll get to painting them and put everything on our shelf and see what it ends up.
Well, I wasn't gonna include this part, but I figured I might just in case some people are wondering if there's like how I did it or what to do. So here we go. For small objects like this, needle nose pliers are the way to go. After I put them in, I take the popsicle stick, so I'm putting even pressure, and then I push down. And what that does is that sits the items on the shelf, and it's flush, like I'm not putting pressure on a different part of the shelf or the object that I'm putting on the shelf, so everything lays flush. Alright, and we're back. So, here is the mini shelf. Thank you for watching.